Hello commanders, welcome back to Star Citizen. Today we are going to take a good look at the new patch for Star Citizen, the 1.1, which brings some really cool new features and additions to the game, such as two new ships, a new multiplayer mode, and a new currency, Rattle Credits, that will make the game a lot more better and a lot more fun to play. First of all, let's take a look at the two new ships. The Retaliator and the Gladius that you see in front of me have been added to the game. The Retaliator is a torpedo bomber that has been redesigned in order to carry a massive cargo capacity and help you become rich in the persistent universe when that will be released in the game in the future. At the moment, the Retaliator is only hangar free, which means that you can buy the package containing the ship or the ship alone and have it at your hangar, while the Gladius have been hangar free for quite a while and it is now finally combat ready. A very strong interceptor, a fast light fighter with focus on laser dog fighting. It is an excellent ship and very beautiful design. It comes with two laser weapons under the wings, one Gatling weapon in the nose, and a lot of missiles to help you hunt down your enemies and destroy them with ease. I have to say that with this new patch the game feels a lot more smoother, it is a lot better than before, and here is the new sim pod that have been added to your hangar, and you can enter inside it and access the arena commander like this. And from here you can choose a spectrum match or a drone sim, which are actually public matches and single player, and access the new multiplayer mode, which is actually a free flight multiplayer that you can access from these menus. You can fly around and roam freely in this multiplayer free flight mode with your friends or other players and have a lot of fun. You can take your ship, go out there, roam freely and have fun with other players or by yourself. There are plenty of possibilities. You can test your ship, test the weapons, the way it handles, the way it accelerates. Of course, take a look at the third person view, admire the ship, the beauty of your ship and the beauty of the Star Citizen universe. There is now a new landing system. You can take your ship and go ahead and land on these new landing pads. There are now 8 in the free flight mode. Landing pads are divided in governed and ungoverned. In order to land in governed landing pads, you will have to ask for permission. If you go ahead and proceed and land without permission, you will have to face some consequences. Most of the time it will be a fine. Let's go ahead and land on this one. Enter in landing mode, and we can do it manually or we can choose the automatic process and just wait for the landing to complete. And here is how you ask for request. Where is it sending us? Over there. Okay, let's follow it. A very cool new system. It will have a lot of use in the persistent universe, of course. And there you go. The automatic process has taken over. And we'll now land to this landing pad. Landing complete. And of course, now that we have landed, we can go out of our ship and take a good look outside. Move around with our character freely, take a good look of our ship, we can explore around the landing pad, we can do everything we like, and we can also take a good look at our character. And this is actually one step closer to the release of the FPS module, which will be a very important module for the Star Citizen in general. Just imagine what you can do like this. You can land, you can dock on other ships and start boarding them, try to steal them, kill everyone. There are plenty of possibilities with the game and I really like the way it's going. And after you are done admiring your beautiful ship like this Gladius, which I believe is absolutely gorgeous, you can go right in there. And of course, take off and leave. Continue your roaming, continue whatever you were doing. A very cool new system. I really like this landing mode. It is making you feel that the game is progressing really good, and I love the way it is, the way it is implemented in the game at the moment. They have said that they will continue improving it, and this is only good. And of course, the new landing system is an excellent way for you to test and take a good look at ships that you don't know. A lot of times the game will give you some ships to test them freely, or you can buy them with rental credits, and we can now, after landing them, we can now take a walk around them, take a good look of them, and decide if this is the ship we want to buy when the persistent universe will be live. Or take a nap in one of them. So for example, I can take this Aurora Land for a stroll, land it in a landing pad, take a good look of it outside and inside, take a good look on the interior, and decide if this is a ship I want to have in the persistent universe. A very good addition overall to the game. I really like this new landing system. And this brings us to the new currency, rental credits, which is called REC, and you can use it to rent ships, weapons and shields. You can rent every ship that is at the moment fly ready in the Arena Commander, and of course you can access all your purchases through the whole tab over here. You can access every ship that you have readied with REC currency. You can equip it with the new weapons or a new shield that you have also readied with this currency. It is an excellent way for the game to reward players for actually playing the game. A very cool new addition. I really like this one as well. The way this works is that when you raid a ship, weapon or shield, you have 7 periods of 24 hours. When you use the ship, a countdown will start, but it will not consume all of these periods, only one period at a time. So for example, if you use this Cutlass Black for once, a countdown of 24 hours will begin, and when it will finish, you will have lost only one day of your equipment, and you will still have 6 more periods of 24 hours to use it whenever you want. Same goes with shields and of course weapons. And if you decide that you want to keep the ship, you like it, you can extend the period. Now, how to gain these credits? Actually, it is very easy. You just get inside the Arena Commander, public matches only of course, and just play. By participating in public matches in every mode, Battle Royale, Capture the Core, Squadron Battle, Cooperative and Dual Swarm of course, and Race, all except Free Flight, you can earn RECs, you can earn rental credits and use them in order to buy new ships, new weapons and of course shields. So the more you play, the more RECs you gain, and the more ships you can unlock, raid, and of course test them in Arena Commander, have fun with them, and enjoy this game, whatever it has to offer. The more you play, the more RECs you earn, and the more your opportunities, the more the fun. If you were considering Star Citizen, if you were considering to play Star Citizen, this is actually the best time to do it, since you can buy a cheap package, a package that contains a ship, one of the starter ships, and you can earn enough RECs, unlock the next ship of your choice, try every ship, weapon until you won, and have fun in the game. That way, when the game will be released, you will know what you want to buy, what suits better for your playstyle. And of course, like I said before, the game feels a lot more smoother, much better than it was. Of course, it has a lot of way in front of it, but it is a lot better now, improved, very improved, and it is a real joy to fly and do combat in it. I really can't wait for the new FPS model that will add a new level on this game. It will make it a real sandbox, it will be a lot of fun to see what they will implement actually. This new patch, Star Citizen 1.1, has brought some really cool new features and changes in the game, especially the new landing system and of course REC, rental credits that will allow you to unlock new ships, rent them and use them in Arena Commander in order to have fun, but not only ships, weapons and shields as well. You can test everything you like and see what suits your playstyle better. It is also one step closer to the FPS module that will be released in the game soon, I hope. And it is very much expected by the players and the community. This is actually the best time to start playing Star Citizen. You can start low with a cheap ship, a cheap package, and earn enough Rex to unlock other ships, every flight ready, combat ready ship at the moment in Arena Commander. And there is always the possibility to join the new multiplayer mode, the free flight multiplayer mode, play with your friends or other players, and have a lot more fun in the game. Thank you for joining me watching this video. I'm Squid of Love, fly safe commanders, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.